really quick. Let me just go ahead and start this video up here. Y'all, this video that I filmed for y'all, the sound is terrible. I understand it's terrible. When I was filming it, I didn't really fully get it. But I bought me a microphone. It will be here for the next video. I didn't know that I was talking that low, but I'm just letting y'all know the sound. Dang, Arla. The sound is low in this video, but if you could just turn it up, bear with me, the next video, the sound will be a lot better. Thanks for watching.
Yeah, y'all, it's locked in a minute. I just been not really processing anything. Just allowing life to just go and not take a minute to process and chat with y'all. That's what be happening. That's why I be stopped filming, but I'm not gonna stop. I'm gonna take a moment, chat with y'all, process, make sure I'm okay. It's me talking with y'all, make sure I'm okay quicker than me not. So I like chatting with y'all. But yeah. But yeah, so let's tell you a story about why I say be careful who you let in your house and all that. So I hit someone up and I'm like, hey, over, he mount my TV on the wall. This TV right here, asked them to come over and mount the TV. They came over, they mounted the TV, everything was fine. Okay, after they did it, I was like, oh, we can leave at the same time. You know, like when I leave, you can leave, like, because I'm about to go anyway. So they were like, cool. So I went in the restroom to potty maybe. It was like 3 minutes of time we were away, but didn't think nothing of it. I'm just going to the bathroom in my home. You know, I leave you to go to the bathroom while I'm in my home. 3 minutes. So I'm not thinking nothing. And then I get in the car and I'm driving out of my apartment. And so I don't see them behind me. You know, like I'm leaving, why you not behind me type stuff. So I called them and I'm like, hey, what's going on? Are you okay? They're like, yeah, I'm just letting my car warm up. Okay. Yeah, whatever. So I just continue to go on with whatever I'm doing, not thinking nothing about it. All right, I get to where I'm going. I do everything. I come home, me and my dog. And yeah, I put my stuff down. And I started hearing this noise. And I'm like, what is that noise? Like, I'm searching everywhere trying to figure out where this noise is coming from. So I asked my dog, I'm like, you hear that noise? And she's like jumping up, you know, basically responding to me, letting me know, yeah, she heard that noise too. So I knew I was in trouble. So I started looking around everywhere trying to see maybe I can hear it and see what's coming from. So I go to my window and I hear it coming from the window. So I'm like, okay, why is that? So instantly I look at it and y'all, my window is open. It's unlocked and it's open. So I'm like, oh shit, why is my window open? So I'm panicking instantly. And I don't want to make too much of a scene, like lift up the blinds and try to close it. So I try to close it discreetly. So if anyone was watching, they wouldn't see me close it. So I try to close it. It wouldn't close. I kept trying. I wouldn't close. I call someone that I know that lives like not too far from me. And I'm like, OMG, I can't close my window. If I needed to come over, can you come over? So they're like, what's going on? Try to close it, you know? So I try to close it, it's not closing. I lift it up, and once I lift it up some more, because you know, at this point I'm just... Yeah, my bad, yeah. At this point, so I'm trying to close it. But at this point, I'm just like, okay, let me try to lift it and then close it. Instead of just pressing it down, trying to close it, let me lift it up to see maybe it's like jammed, then try to close it. So I lift it up, and when I lift it up, I see this, like, nail or screw. I see it like a screw. I see a screw in it. And not even a screw. It's not a screw. It's like, it was spiral, but it had no top and no bottom. So it looked like just like a stick that was spiral. So I'm like, okay, why is this black in the window? You know, why is it open and then why is the stick right here? So I'm like, OMG, I moved the stick, I closed the window, I locked the window, and I start panicking. Like, what happened? So I hang up with the person I know lives down the street. I hang up on them and I'm like, OMG, what happened? Like, why is my window open? Why is there a stick in my window? What's going on? When did this gonna happen? Then I started instantly thinking. I did go to the bathroom for like 3 minutes while they were in my home. They could have opened my window, you know? So I instantly like, OMG, like, did they really, when I went to the restroom, open my window, put a nail in there because they had tools for when they came to mount the TV. So I'm like, did they really just sit there and do that? And then I'm thinking, you remember I told you when I left, was like pulling out of the apartment and they were still in the apartment? My dad is going to make them like facial expression drops. I'm just freaking out a little bit. Again. So I was thinking when I were leaving out and they were still in the apartment, did they do something, you know, like come to my window and all that? Because that was odd, you know, like that was really odd. And that never was a thing. Like before they come, I didn't hear no whistling ever because I have really, really good ears. Like I can hear very well. And then my dog, she has great ears. She can hear very well. So we know when it's a sound. Like, I don't even like the pen click, 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 the tap. I don't like no sounds because I can hear it very loud. So that just occurred. And I'm just like, yeah, y'all, that spooked me. I bought cameras and all types of systems and everything because another story, when I was a small child, my whole family, we lived in a house and we all went out to eat to CC's. We came back from CC's. Everything in our apartment was stolen because of my mom's window was open. So I think maybe she was dating a guy. Same thing happened. He opened the window. He knew we left. Came into the window, took everything, and left our home empty when we came back from CC's. So that was traumatic, but that was when I was like probably 7 years old. I'm a grown woman now, and that having the window open brought back that trauma for when that did happen. And yeah, I say this to you too, if you do allow people to come over, whether it's your friends, your family, anyone, make sure that you check after they leave. Please do. Like, let me move this and come a little closer. Make sure you check after each person leaves your home. Because you never know what they left in your home. You don't know if they left in, well, you don't know if they opened your window while you're in the bathroom so they can come back in, or they unlocked the back door when you were leaving. Like, you don't know people's motives. And yes, it's sad to say, but you can have a crackhead uncle and you let him in your house and he asks you the bathroom and he goes and unlocks the window, comes back in through that window and take everything. So I said that to say, be careful who you let in. And if you do let people in, just triple check when they leave. Check your purse. Make sure you have all your money. Check your savings or whatever you have. Make sure everything is still there when they leave. You know? So make sure all your windows are locked. Make sure your phone is where your phone is. Your keys are where your keys is. Your purse is where your purses are. Just make sure everything is where it's supposed to be when they leave. Check your windows. Check your doors. Check your locks every time a guest leaves your home. And I'm just saying that for safety reasons, especially if you live alone. And yeah, people are definitely trying to take advantage of you out there. They'll try to make it seem like they're your friend or they're trying to butter you up or whatever. But you can't put anything past anyone. So please be aware that when someone leaves your area, just check after them. You know, just, oh, okay, bye. I mean, I'll make sure all my windows are locked, my doors are locked, my money is in my wallet. You know, just make sure. I know it's sad to say that you have to really check after people leave your home, but it's so very important because if I would never check once they left my home after mounting my TV and I didn't notice or hear that sound, they could have came in my apartment and did whatever they wanted to do. They know my work schedule, they know where I live apparently, they know they just mounted a TV on my wall and what's in at least my living room, you know, so just be cautious and safe. 2023, it's going to be 2024 in about 6 days. Wait, what's today? Hey Siri, what's today's date?
It's Thursday, the 21st of December, 2023.
Yeah, Thursday, the 21st of December, 2023. You still have to make sure that you're batting eyes and crossing your T's. So make sure that every time a guest leaves your home, you check your windows, make sure they're locked, check your purse, make sure you have your wallet and your money. And just make sure everything where it needs to be. Okay, thank you guys so much for watching. Be safe and trust your instincts. If you hear a sound, don't overstep that. Go find out where that sound is coming from. You hear a whistling, don't stop until you find the whistling. You hear anything, don't stop until you figure out what it is. That's something I learned about from having a dog. Because they're not gonna stop until they figure out where that's coming from. And me personally, neither. Hey y'all, I'm a little bit too busted. I just got in the house, I'm tired, I'm hungry. But I just want to make this video, y'all. Thank you guys so much for watching. Give it a thumbs up, subscribe. So we can be friends and y'all can get to know me. But hey y'all, bye. Bye. Hello. Yeah, I know you're being a good girl. Yep.